Hello guys, would you like to learn how double-stranded DNA forms? I'm here to talk about the DNA simulator. It is our recent addition to the list of scientific games and simulations, and now you can use it to understand the behavior of DNA and the forces that affect on it. DNA simulator begins with 8 strands of DNA. Here each circle represents a nucleotide, including the base, sugar, and the phosphate. The nucleotides connected to each other forms a single-stranded DNA. And now you can see that they are forming double-stranded DNA, aka duplex. They are also held together by the help of the cations, and they are represented with small white circles. Now I would like to show you how each parameter actually is going to affect the DNA formation, starting with the cations. And the cations are very important for duplex formation because they keep the DNA together. And they do that by counteracting the repulsion between the phosphates of the nucleotides. Now if you remove the cations, then the phosphates will be able to repel each other and the DNA strands will separate. Here I'll drop the cation count to 0 and you'll see that quickly DNA separates. Now if we add them back, you will see that first the cations find the DNA and then they will help them overcome the effect of the phosphate repulsion, and they will come together to form duplex DNA. If there are too many cations, it can actually have a negative effect on the proper DNA formation. That's why we limited the cation count to 20. You can see on the graph, about 70% of all nucleotides form hydrogen bonds. The second parameter I will show is the temperature. It is expected that with increasing temperature, the double-stranded DNA will separate. Now I will increase it from 120 to about 400. The hydrogen bond formation ratio drops. I'll drop it back to 120. And I'd like to note that this number has an arbitrary unit, so don't confuse it with Celsius or Fahrenheit. Please note, when I increase the temperature, the hydrogen bond formation ratio drops really fast. When I decrease the temperature again, the hydrogen bond formation doesn't rise as quickly. That is because DNA strands need to find each other, which takes some time. I also would like to note that if we decrease the temperature too low, then we wouldn't be able to see the formation of the duplexes. That is something we also see in the laboratory. If we were to put melted DNA into ice, then they don't tend to form duplexes. Here I'll show you, we'll increase the temperature and have them melt again. And they're pretty much separated. Now decrease the temperature to 0 and that will cause them to freeze and they will not have time to form duplexes. That's why we decrease the temperature slowly so that we can have the DNAs form duplex again. Another feature of our DNA simulator is entering new sequences. We can remove the existing ones from add and remove sequence section. And here you can see the list of sequences we have, and I'll remove all of them using the remove button. And now I will enter a DNA sequence that will actually form a hairpin structure. And I will click the add button and here is my new DNA. Now the cations come closer, and once there are enough cations, the duplex is going to fold on itself and form a hairpin. I hope you found this video interesting and useful. You can find a link to the simulator in the description below. Please like if you enjoyed this video so we can keep making more simulations like this one.
Quote, quote, wave.
Fine, quote, me, quote. Me, I keep making.
Quote.